Let's talk for a minute about the power of now. There's a great book on that that is something that I recommend. You could probably get it on Amazon. The amazing thing that I have seen over the past 30 plus years of ministry is most people do not live in the now. They are distressed, sometimes greatly distressed, by something that happened in the past. I've told the story many times, especially when I'm speaking around the country, about a woman that came to my office one day, so distressed, crying, and after about a half an hour of holding her hand and talking to her and consoling her and trying to comfort her, I asked when this happened. And I remember clearly, I thought that she would say it happened yesterday or this morning. She told me it happened in 1957. You know, it wasn't really that big of thing when she told me about it, but that's the mind. The mind magnifies things over time. Every time it replays, it grows bigger and bigger. And this was years later. It was in the 90s, and I just thought this woman had something happen to her in 1957 and was never able to go on from there. Well, it says in Psalms 118, verse 24, "This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." This is the day. It's not the past. It's not the future. It is important for us to give our full attention to what is at hand. And this takes a retraining of mind. It takes an active thinking on our part until it becomes habit. Now, if not, we may think about the past or the future so much that we fail to extract the joy that is in the present moment of now. When we are fully interested in what is happening now, we become vitally alive. We welcome today with complete interest. We concentrate on the present moment, even if it may seem routine. We find interesting new experiences. Anything you focus on, you'll focus on it to a point that you find something new and even exciting in it. As we demonstrate a genuine interest in others, listen to and remember what they communicate to us, life becomes engaging again. Let us begin by affirming, "I am vitally alive and interested in what is happening now." I am vitally alive and interested in what is happening now. Let us affirm these words at various intervals during the day, and we find that our attitude towards living resounds throughout our bodies, and it becomes something that causes us to wake up and become alive again.